Rogelio Rivera, known as Roy to his friends, is a successful commercial real estate broker and owns Plaza Realty. Despite his success, Roy came from humble beginnings. He was born on June 2, 1952, to Crisoro and Delia Rivera.
My father immigrated from Mexico in 1945. He came with my mom. They gave him what they called a green card. And with that green card, he was given permission to work and to live here in the States.
Roy grew up in Far and attended PSA schools. He started in the first grade at Buell School and later went to Ford, Buckner, and Edison.
From Edison, went on to Jefferson, which eventually became a ninth grade campus, Jefferson Junior High in seventh and eighth grade.
His father was an entrepreneur.
He opened up a produce business. My daddy was a very hard worker, and he was very successful too. And he had his produce business. I remember we would receive vegetables and fruits, tomatoes, potatoes, onions, and so forth. And we would deliver them to the local restaurants. Sometimes businesses fail. And my father's business failed. And when it did, I had a postcard from a friend who had gone, whose family had gone to Salinas, California. And all I had was an address.
Based on the address from his friend's postcard, Roy's family, along with his uncle's family, packed up and moved to California, where they worked as migrant workers. And Roy spent over a year there at Riverside High School.
I did ninth grade there. I did about one semester of my 10th grade. And then I had that wantingness to come back to PSJA. I fought my dad tooth and nail when I was in California. He did not want to let me come. He said, son, we're family and we're going to stay here. I said, Dad, I want to go to PSJA. I said, I love PSJA. And I finally got him, convinced him to let me come.
Roy and his sister drove back to Texas, and he attended and graduated from PSJA High School. Roy remembers the teachers that made a difference in his life.
In the third grade, I had Miss Sines. She was a lovely person. She was very nice with us. She was very encouraging. In the fourth grade, I remember Mr. Trigo. I think his first name was Roel Trigo. He was awesome. He was my science teacher. So he had an influence on me wanting to go into biology or the biological sciences. In the 10th grade, I remember Mrs. Dora Dykus. She was super. She was a very good person. She was a very good teacher. She was always inspiring us to go forward, to move forward, you know, that you can do better. I also had Miss Salisbury for Algebra 2, I remember. Miss Salisbury was probably one of the kindest persons that I ever met. She was just super nice. And then in the elective field, I had Mrs. Gloria Potter. Miss Potter was a very nice lady. You know, we had the old typewriters. We had no computers back then. There were about maybe 5-7 electric typewriters in the classroom, so we were always fighting for the electric typewriters. I was class of 1971. I graduated at midterm. Right after graduation, I went directly into the university. And I was a migrant from the age of 13 up until the age of about 22. I was already in college, and I was still a migrant, going to work out in the fields. So it was about 10 years. It was very hard work. I was 21. I told Dad, I want to finish college. I don't want to do this for the rest of my life. And my mother was always, go to school, go to school, get your degree. My dad was a very good provider, but he wasn't much into the education thing. But my mother, she didn't want us to stay in the fields. We were five siblings, and all five of us went to school.
Roy earned a Bachelor's of Science degree at Pan American University in 1974, with a major in biology and a minor in physical science and another minor in English. That same year, he began teaching.
I started teaching at PSJA Jefferson. I taught 7th grade science and English. The next year, I moved on to the high school. I started to teach physical science and biology. And so I had another few years of teaching at that grade level.
Roy feels that much of his success comes from the encouragement and affirmation of his wife, Ivanella, and his two sons, Rogelio and Fernando.
I think that having gotten married, having a family, brought a balance to my life. It made me happier. And somewhere along the line, being that my father was a businessman, I had that urge to learn about business. So at age about 25, 26, I decided to go to real estate school on my spare time. And it was very, very interesting. This was around 1976. I became a licensed real estate agent. And by 1979, I was a real estate broker. So in 1981, I decided to open up a business, a real estate business. I did real estate between 81 and 87. Of course, I was not too familiar with the way that the economy functioned. I didn't know what a recession was. In 1987, we had a recession. I had a lot of properties on the market, but I couldn't understand why people didn't want to buy.
Roy had already earned a master's degree in education administration in 1979, and with the real estate slump, he decided to go back to work in education.
I went back to finish what they called the mid-management certification, which gave me a license to practice as a school principal. And I went from 1988 to 1990 and did that. And eventually in 1988, I went back to teaching. That's when we had the recession. I did 3 years in Hidalgo.
After a few years of teaching in Hidalgo ISD, Roy was offered an assistant principal position at Mission Junior High.
I was an assistant principal for 11 years, and then I was a school principal for 4 years. I gave everything I could to Mission Junior High. Loved the kids, loved the parents, had a great time.
While working at Mission CISD, Roy had a growing desire to get back into real estate.
And I told my wife when I was about 54, 55, I said, if I don't do it now, I'm never going to do it. So, you know, once I was eligible for retirement, I went ahead and retired and moved on. And here I am, and it's been great. At the end of my education career in 2006, my office was already open when I retired. In this business, you have to go meet people. You have to go and list property. You have to put you have to put your sign on a property. You have to let people know that you're in business. And your sign is your best form of advertisement. And the more listings you have, the better off your chances are of being successful. I do sell a lot of properties in the PSA area because that's where I grew up. But I've got signs in San Benito. I've got signs in Dana. I have a sign in Sullivan City. I mean, I've got it's all over the place. And when people see your signs, sometimes they call and they say, hey, can you sell my property too?
Roy encourages young people to pursue their education.
School is your ticket to success. I know that there are stories of successful people who never went to college and successful people who didn't graduate high school. Those are the exception to the rule. There may be a few out there, but the norm, the rule, the more school you have, the more successful you're going to be.
He stresses that it's never too late to go to college.
My brother Robert was a teacher at Austin Middle School. He just retired this last year, and he was 40 years old when he went to get his degree. And he graduated at the age of 44. Went, taught for about 20 years, 21 years, but he had already been a paraprofessional. So I think he had about 25 or 26 years experience in the field. He retired last year.
He feels a great part of his success came from the love of his parents, grandparents, and his aunts.
I succeeded because I had unconditional love from all my family. And this is where we as parents also need to provide unconditional love to our children.
Roy feels he's right where he wants to be.
I mean, it's been a great ride. I love what I'm doing now. I got success has come, and my sons are doing great. Even have a granddaughter that my son adopted. Everything's good.